Welcome back to part two of Tracheostomy Care. Next up, we're going to clean the inner cannula of the tracheostomy and clean around the site. The supplies that you need in order to perform tracheostomy care include a new set of trach ties or a trach collar, some sterile normal saline, hydrogen peroxide for cleaning, and a sterile tracheostomy kit. And I need two pairs of sterile gloves. I'm now going to open up my table to give me a larger working surface. I have already identified the patient, I've washed my hands, and I've also told the patient what we're going to do. I want to go ahead and loosen the missed collar so it's easier to remove. I'm going to loosen the cap of my sterile normal saline, and I'm going to loosen the hydrogen peroxide as well. I'm going to open up my tracheostomy kit. So remember, the 1-inch border around my sterile field is considered non-sterile. Next, I'm going to place my gloves on, and I'm just going to put one glove on, and arrange my supplies on my field, pour my solutions, and then put my second glove on. I'm going to move this out of my way without turning my back on my field or my patient. I am right-handed, so I'm going to actually put my right glove on, and I don't have a problem pouring with my left. If you had a problem pouring with your left, then you would want to make sure that you put your left glove on and so that you're able to pour with your right hand. I'm going to put my right hand on, step away. I now need to arrange my supplies on my sterile field. The first thing on the top of your tray kit is actually a sterile drape in order to put on the patient's chest. I'm going to go ahead and move my mist collar, and I'm going to drape my patient. The shiny side goes down. I don't want to lean over my field. I can touch in the middle of the field, but not around the 1-inch border. So I'm now going to arrange the supplies on my field. I'm going to pull out my pipe cleaners, which you're going to use for drying the tracheostomy. These are little sterile tweezers that you can use to help place the new dressing underneath the tray collar. This is the brush to clean inside the tracheostomy tube. New twill tape for securing the tracheostomy. We're actually going to use the Velcro tray collars instead of the ties. There are some sterile 4x4s that you can use for drying the tracheostomy. I'm actually going to put put these supplies up at the top here. There is also the new drain sponge for under the trach. Then I also have 3 Q-tips for cleaning around the skin and the trach. There are 3 containers. It's a little hard to get the 2 undone sometimes. So in the first container, we're going to pour the hydrogen peroxide. The second container is going to be the sterile normal saline for drying. And then the third container is going to have some sterile normal saline in order to clean around the stoma and on the face of the trach. I'm going to walk around the table without leaning over any of my sterile fields. And I'm going to come around to get my hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is the first container. So I need enough hydrogen peroxide in order to clean the entire trach tube. And we're just cleaning the inner cannula. Okay. Again, I'm not turning my back on my field, and we now need, actually I'm going to just put that out of the way since I don't need it anymore. And then I have my sterile normal saline. Loosen my cap. I'm going to put my cap facing up. When you first pull out your supplies, you want to make sure that this bottle has not expired. If you are the first one to open this bottle, you want to make sure that you label it with your initials, the date, and the time that the bottle was opened. Most institutions have a 24-hour policy. After 24 hours, this is no longer considered sterile. I'm going to go ahead and pour into my second container. And then into my third container. I want to avoid splashing. If you splash and wet your sterile field, it is considered non-sterile. Replace my cap. I no longer need this bottle, so I'm going to put it to the side. Next, I'm going to put on my second sterile glove. This time I did not get my fingers in correctly. There we go. Okay. I cannot reach below my wrist. If I touch below my wrist, then I have contaminated my gloves. What I need to do now is remove the inner cannula of the tracheostomy, and then I will remove the old dressing that is around the tracheostomy. You want to twist and remove. I'm going to go ahead and put the inner cannula inside the hydrogen peroxide. I'm then going to remove the old dressing from underneath the trach faceplate. So we look for any drainage. I'm going to wrap the old dressing in my gloves and discard my gloves. Without turning my back on my sterile field and my patient, I'm going to go ahead and hand sanitize. So the only time you have to wash the inner cannula or remove it and clean it is for someone that has a non-disposable inner cannula. If the patient has a disposable inner cannula, all you do is remove the old one, replace it with a clean, new, sterile inner cannula, and then clean around the faceplate and replace the gauze dressing. You do not have to use hydrogen peroxide to clean the cannula. You just insert a new one. In my right hand is a disposable inner cannula, and in my left hand is the non-disposable inner cannula. Okay, so I'm going to put on my second pair of sterile gloves. There we go. Okay, now I'm ready to clean. So I'm gonna grab the brush to clean the tube. You wanna clean around the outside. You wanna put the brush inside to clean. Once you have gotten all of the crusty mucus off, you're gonna go ahead and put the tracheostomy into the sterile normal saline. And this is for rinsing, so you wanna make sure that you get the normal saline through the tube. I am then gonna dry my tracheostomy over my sterile field. That's just in case I drop it, that it doesn't land on something unsterile. Want my sterile 4x4s. To dry the outside. I can dry inside by using the pipe cleaners. You can usually fit one or two through there at a time, just one way. Let me do that one more time. So those are considered not sterile now because I threw them off of the field. I'm just going to use the third one just to make sure that it's sterile. I want to observe the trach just to make sure that I don't see any obvious damage or any lint inside. If I need to dry one more time, I can. We are now ready to replace the tracheostomy tube into the tracheostomy in the patient. I'm now going to replace the inner cannula and lock it in place. You want to turn the tube until it locks. And you can see on the tube there is a blue dot for this cannula that is on the inner cannula, and then there's a blue dot on the part that is in the patient, and you want to match those up to make sure that they're locked. You can also feel a little click and hear a little click when it clicks into place. We're now going to clean around the faceplate. So I need the three Q-tips, and we're going to be using that last basin that has the sterile normal saline. We're going to make sure the Q-tips are moist, and then I'm going to use the first one. You want to clean around the tracheostomy. You want to clean the faceplate. Okay, so I'm cleaning the faceplate. I'm going to get rid of that dirty Q-tip. I also need to clean underneath the faceplate, around the stoma. I'm gonna get rid of that Q-tip. So I use three Q-tips for cleaning. Before your procedure, if you notice that the patient's faceplate and around the stoma has a lot of discharge or is very dirty, you can add some additional sterile Q-tips to your field at the beginning to make sure you have enough in order to clean properly around the site. So now I'm going to reach for my forceps and my drain sponge. If you look at the drain sponge, you can see that it has a cut, and there are no frayed edges, so you don't have to worry about any of the frayed edges getting into the patient's airway. So the cut is going to slide up underneath the faceplate. You want the sealed part at the bottom of the tracheostomy, so if you have any drainage, the skin will be protected. So during this part, you are going to become contaminated. There's just no way around trying to put gauze sponges underneath the faceplate. You try your best to make sure that this part does not touch anything so that it is as sterile as possible around the stoma. You can use the forceps to help you reach. So now that I have the dressing back underneath the faceplate, I need to change the trach ties. If you are alone, you do not want to remove the other trach ties until you have the new ones in place. If you have a second person with that can hold the tracheostomy in place, you could remove the old tracheostomy ties. You never want to have your trach unsecured, because if the patient coughs, that trach could be dislodged. This is not a sterile part of the procedure. The sterile part ended when we started to put the dressing underneath the faceplate. Since I am alone, I'm going to put my new trach collar on at the same time as I have my old trach collar on. Gonna reach behind your neck here to get the new trach collar in. And I need to tighten this one. This one's a little loose for the patient. So I have both sides secured, but now I need to make sure it's in the correct position and tight enough. This is looking a little loose. When I have the trach collar in the correct position, I should be able to get one to two fingers between the trach collar and the patient's skin. If you have more fingers between, you can fit more fingers between the trach collar and the patient's skin, it means that your collar is too loose. I'm going to go ahead and remove the old trach collar. I can discard that. So now that I have the trach collar in place, I'm going to double check. I can fit one to two fingers comfortably, but I wouldn't be able to fit a third without hurting the patient. I want to replace my missed collar. So that concludes the end of the tracheostomy video, suctioning as well as tracheostomy care. I still need to dispose of my gloves and dispose of my supplies. To leave my patient, I need to make sure that the side rail is up, they have their call light, and they are in a comfortable position. Thank you so much for joining us, and I hope to see you next time.